Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to use the Warfare Photoshop action and how to customize the effect when the action has finished. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna make from this photo this effect using this action. I got a few more examples here. Here I have changed the color of some particles and of fire camouflage from this to this. Here I hidden some of the layers and I used some black and white effects. And from this photo to this, here I have changed the colors using the one of 15 color options. Okay, now I will close down these windows. To open your photo, you need to go to File, Open, choose your photo and just click Open. To load the action, go to Window, Actions, click on this little arrow here, Load Actions, and just choose the action that came with download. Okay, here it is. Before you play the action, you need to make sure that your photo is a background layer. If it's something like this or anything else, you just need to go to Layer, New, and choose Background from Layer. And as you see, now it's a background layer. And make sure that the image mode is a RGB color mode, 8-bit Canon. Also, what you need to check is the image size. For best results, use the images that are around 2000 pixels wide and high. So I'll set this to 2000 pixels, and the resolution should be 300. Okay, now make a new layer, name it brush. All letters must be lowercase, and just take some pick some brush. I will use the soft brush and brush the areas that you want to where you want to apply the effect. Yeah, I have done this before. Here it is. And now just select the action and click play. Action takes about 1 to 2 minutes to complete. It depends on your image size. So I'll stop the video here and now play the action. Okay, the action has just stopped. So first we're gonna do, I will close down this window and you will see that a layer Warfare will be selected. Hold the Ctrl and Alt button and just click on this little arrow here. That will close down all the folders. We are here the brush layer, and the action is made so every time you run the action you will get a unique result, so even if you use the same brushed area. So this fire camouflage will always have a different shape, and also the camouflage in the background and the camouflage strokes and so on. So what you can do, you can select these two layers, remove them and turn on the visibility of this layer, and you can play the action again and you will get a unique result. Okay. Here we got the adjustment group. Here is the Add Sharpen layer. Here we got the Add Contrast layer. I set the opacity to 20. If you want to increase the contrast, just increase this value here. Okay, and here we got the 15 color options. You just need to choose the color option that you like and just turn on its visibility. So, and you can experiment to see which one suits best to your photo. And so on. Okay, here is the Warfare group. This is actually the whole effect. Here we got the main photo group. So what I usually do, I turn on the visibility of this layer. Now these two layers will be shown also. So I will this is the black and white effect. I will turn off its visibility, and here we got the brightness and contrast. This layer affects only your model. So if you change any value here, he will change only your model, not the background and other. Okay. Here we got the change colors layer. All you need to do is to double click here and change the value of hue. Okay, here we get the particles group. If you want to increase the visibility of the particles, what you can do, you can change its blending mode to normal and they will become a little bit more visible. What you can also do, you can turn on this layer and now change the color of the particles. I'll set now to pastoral, and what you can do also, if you want to create more particles, you can duplicate any of this group or duplicate the whole folder. Select this folder here and now you can transform them as you like. I will turn off the color to this group, but I will leave it here. You can move the particles, of course. Okay, here we got the camo strokes glows. So that is the glow of camouflage strokes that we got here. We got the horizontal glow. You can choose from, you got the stroke glow, horizontal glow, and vertical glow. So you just choose the one that you like, and you can also increase its visibility here. If you want to even increase more the visibility of this layer, you can duplicate it and make it more visible. Okay. Here we got the fire camouflage and fire camo glows. That is a glow of fire camouflage, of course. So we got the fire camo glow, we got the fire camo horizontal glow, and the fire camo vertical glow. I'll choose the vertical glow. If you want to increase the glow even more, just duplicate this layer by going right click and go to duplicate layer. Here it is. And if you want to make this fire camouflage goes over your model, what you can do, you can hold down control button and select the fire camouflage layer that you want, for example this one, and then select the layer mask of your photo, set foreground color to black, and go to edit, fill foreground color, and here it is. I will select the this layer too, and you can control you can hold the control shift button, and then you can select a few layers at once. Now I'm gonna go fill again. Okay, and what you can also do here, you can take a brush, set foreground color to black, and just remove some parts of your model layer. I'll remove it a little bit above the fire camouflage because of the fire camo glow to become more visible. Like this. If you remove the model on some place and you want to get it back, just set foreground color to white, and when click on the place where you want to get back the model. So I remove move it a little bit right here. Okay. What you got here? Also, you got the black camel layer. They can give a nice effect when they are above the fire camel layer. Then the fire looks a little bit more realistic. So you can also click here to create its layer mask. Take a brush tool and remove it on places where you want. Okay. Here we got the your photo layer. Its color mode is hard light, so this layer is not too much visible. If you turn off reveal your photo layer, you see. Okay, here we got the background texture and camouflage texture. Here you can choose the camo color. Just turn on the visibility of this layer, double click here and choose the any color that you want. But also when you change the colors using this layer, you will change the background color too. And if you want to make the camouflage black and white, just turn on the visibility of this layer. What you can do also, you can turn on the visibility of this layer and then lower its opacity. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna just desaturate a little bit background. I'll set it about this. You can also do the same with your model. And here we got the background color. So what I've set the color to black. So we have a little bit more contrast, and now change the colors a little bit, like this. And also about this layer, if you move any of these layers, there will be some lines. So if you change anything on the photo, remove this layer, and when you finish with customizing, make it again this way. Make a new layer above add contrast layer. Go to image, apply image. Okay, and then go to other high pass. Set value to 2, and set its blending mode to linear light. Okay, here you can lower the sharpen if you want by lowering the value of opacity. I'll set it to 100. And also, if you want to remove any particle, any camouflage strokes, you can do that using the layer mask. So just if you want to remove fire camouflage in some places, select it. Layer mask, take a brush tool, set foreground color to black, and just click on places where you want to remove it. And it's the same with particles. So, and if you want to get them back, just set the foreground color to white, and that's it. It is the same with strokes, camouflage strokes. And also, what you can do, you can move the fire camouflage parts, for example. I select this one, and you can place it here if you want. Then I will go to main photo, set foreground color to black, and remove the model on this place now, because now I got the fire camouflage here. And I set foreground color to white to remove this. And you will see that now you don't have a glow on this layer, So what you need to do is to select the fire camouflage layer that you have moved or transformed, and color layer above him, and duplicate them. Click right click and go to merge layers, and then go to filter blur, choose the motion blur, and if you want to make a vertical glow, set angle to 19 and distance about 300. Click OK. For horizontal glow, you need to set the angle to 0, and for simple glow, just then use Gaussian blur and set value about 80, 90. Okay, now and change its blending mode to linear dodge. Okay, now I'll get back to model layer and remove it up and down of fire camo layer to reveal the glow, and that's it. As I said, here you can change the colors. And that's it. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you got any questions, feel free to contact me via my Envato profile page.